Welcome to the Police Stop Podcast.
Oh, I love just starting like that. And is this my Red Bull or yours?
That's yours. I don't
Thank
drink
you.
The sugar-free ones. You look...
Thanks.
...like a Coke dealer for...
The Gap?
Willy Wonka's Chocolate Factory.
I feel like I look like a Wook that sells 16-year-olds Adderall. You know what a Wook is? You know what a Wook is? Like well, you're kind of behind me. This is interesting.
Is weird, I'm like a weird angle.
Looking over at you.
So,
whoa, we got fucked up. I should probably be like,
yeah, there you go. Like this. Let's be more casual.
Yeah, play it cool, bro.
I need to posture up here. Yeah, I'm just trying to not wear black.
Yeah, what's a Wook?
A Wook is someone who has like dreadlocks and goes to those concerts in the fest in the like the not the ones indoors but the ones outdoors where no one showers and you wear like beads and shit.
Those people like Coachella, like
yeah. And I might be butchering the definition of Wook, but they're undesirables to say the least. They are dirty and they smell and they listen to questionable music. They probably also like ICP. They like like things like Bass Nectar and like. Yeah,
dude. What does that mean?
Someone out there's like,
is that a real like? What does that mean? Does it mean like
Wook?
No, bass.
you just described. It's like it's a musician. That's one of those like.
I know what
like,
it is.
He's like, I'm into crystals and drum and bass.
Oh, okay.
He's one of those guys.
So I looked up Wook on Urban Dictionary. Is a hippie without any ambition, motivation, or drive other than drugs and image.
Yeah.
They're missing the key detail in that they fucking stink.
They stink.
And they suck to be around. They generally don't give a fuck about anything.
Well, I think that's the lack of motivation.
So right. They clean themselves. Yeah, they're very narcissistic. Yeah. And other words.
Took my stapler.
Yeah, dude, it's spring.
Went golfing yesterday.
Yeah, it's golfing. You went on a date with two dudes yesterday. You dated two different men yesterday.
Three dudes, technically.
Three dudes? You even stopped by here for a quickie.
I did, actually. Four dudes yesterday.
He's a serial friend.
Mm.
Serial friending.
It's like the most I've done in one day in a long. And I worked in the morning.
Golfing. You worked.
Uh huh.
With a bunch of dudes. You got off work and you came here for a quickie. Then you fucking went golfing with another man.
Yeah.
And then you went and went on a date with him.
Yeah. Where'd and his cousin go? Was there. So that's two dudes. And we sat at a bar.
And you did aggro fucking men shit. You guys punched.
No, I sat there and was just like, what the fuck is going on the whole time? While these, well, mostly him, Levi, was going bonkers. He just has that. He's just hyper. I don't get it.
So what you're saying is you lost the fucking.
Oh, yeah. No, I lost. I missed it 2 out of 4 times.
Even when he hit it, he missed it.
Yeah, I didn't.
Did you
even
roast
really,
him on the spot, or were you quiet because it was awkward?
No, they did. I was.
You're like, oh.
So in this like restaurant, it's like part bar restaurant, and then there's like a little area with like a pool table and like the punching machine. And back there was like a bunch of 16-year-old kids playing pool.
Teenagers.
And
dude.
So we're doing this in front of these
like
little
Stranger
kids.
Things back there, bro. Just a group of kids doing cool shit that cool kids do in and little nowhere towns.
And then Dylan's throwing a 120 punch power on this thing, and they're like eyeing him up like he's a piece of meat.
Bro, would have fucked any of those kids up. 100%.
Oh, okay. I'm glad that sentence kept going. Bro, would have fucked any of those kids up.
Yeah, dude. Just what a... They knew it. They knew it. Oh, whatever, dude.
They're going to rape him in the parking lot.
The whole time, though, the most embarrassing part was standing there being openly like, this is just the worst display of any sort of like,
oh, because it's like
masculinity
in front of the rest of the bar.
I'm no, just the children. There's no other crowd other than these 16-year-olds and then another 60-year-old that walked back at one point. They're like, what are you kids doing back here? And I'm like, nothing. Trump 2020.
Yeah.
And he left. He was just so excited that he.
They're like, our generation doesn't have a war worth fighting, so we do shit like axe throwing. And
yeah.
Do you know,
I was thinking about
contests.
That the other day. And do you think axe throwing's cool? Would you do it?
I'd be down to try it. Yeah.
Okay, it's stupid. Like it's that wasn't directed at you.
Is it not a useful skill?
How for what? Deer hunting?
I don't know. You know, they may turn the lights off and take all the guns and all you have is you and your axe. You ever heard the hatchet before? You might crash in a plane in the woods and you have to fight off wolves with like a little small hatchet. And if you knew how to
survival
throw
game.
It, if you knew how to throw it, that would be an advantage, correct? You know what I mean? It's a practical skill.
But why It's dumber than escape rooms, I think. Like, the trend of their
escape room's the widest thing ever. Your life is so easy. You're like, let's pretend like we're in trouble.
Yeah.
Well, let's pretend like someone's trying to get us.
Yeah, and so is the axe throwing thing. Let's go pretend we're lumberjacks. Guess what real lumberjacks are like? We don't have time to throw our axes.
Well, okay.
Our tools.
Is it a pro sport?
Probably. ESPN Ocho, bro. Anything's a pro sport.
It's only a pro sport in Mexico.
No, do you not know what ESPN Ocho is?
They're like, hey, we're out of pro sports. Hey. Mexico's like, but we didn't get anything besides soccer. They're like, well, we do have axe throwing and that thing where you put the bag in the hole. They're like, oh, con hole. I'm like, yeah, you can have both of those professionally. They're like, oh, gracias.
All right.
That was just unnecessary.
I know.
Because it just didn't even work.
And when it bombs, it sounds racist. And when it doesn't, it's like a free ticket. It's like a free ticket.
If people laugh, you're golden.
If they laugh, don't laugh, like, ah,
fuck.
Heil Hitler. I get you, dude. You know, but if you miss,
it's like you miss.
Dude.
Come
have you guys, are you guys
nope.
up? Are you guys abreast about current events?
No.
Are you guys watch the news?
Absolutely not.
Do you know the latest viral stories?
Nope.
You guys aren't like on
not
TikTok?
Not all of them.
Not all of them? I deleted
Facebook and Snapchat.
Do you know about the Ever Given?
Nope.
Ever Given. Does it ring a bell?
No.
Ever Given.
No bell given. Ringing.
No bells ringing?
No bell given.
It's the name of a ship.
Oh, this is the one that,
name
that
of
blocked
a ship that
the
got
canal.
Stuck.
Yeah.
Okay.
And
okay.
the first time okay. the news story came like up, like, oh, big ship stuck in the Suez Canal. I'm like, cool, what a fucking boring story, right? It's like a cat caught in a tree. Didn't cross my mind. You know, boat's too big, right? You know, whoops. It got unstuck, and they were showing like the traffic jam of ships from space. I'm like, you know, the boats are too big, right? The boats are too, they're too fucking big. It gets unstuck. Yay, everyone gets to, you know, take fucking drugs to Egypt or whatever
trillions
the fuck.
Trillions of dollars a day.
Millions and
lost.
Trillions, and it's just this. Every, like, oh my God. Yeah. It's stuck again.
Is it really?
I swear to God. Hey, boat's too big. Did you ever given it a thought that maybe the boat's too big? Especially you named it Ever Given. You should have probably been like, hey, like one guy, one friend from accounting could have been like, hey, boat's too big. Like, no, it's fucking not. It's not like it's going to get stuck in the Suez Canal. The boat is too big. When is a boat to get too big? When it gets stuck in between two countries. Hey, the boat's too big. Stop making them bigger.
So why does online say it all got cleared up yesterday and all the ships are through?
No, it got stuck somewhere else now, man. Am I fucking reading fake news right now, Brien?
Yeah. Oh, we lost it.
Perfect time for a break. We can edit out my fake news.
Anyways, as you were saying, that the boat is now unstuck and it's moving on its way.
It's moving now, but it got stuck again.
A second time.
Like, take the fucking cars off the fucking whatever. Take the fucking bananas, put them on shore, let the boat go. Let the people eat the bananas. I don't know. Like, at what point do you just blow it up? You know what I mean? Blow it, fucking nuke the ship.
I don't think they're quite there yet. Maybe soon. I don't know.
Dig a bigger canal.
Yeah, like, fucking the boat's too big, dude. Make smaller boats or a bigger canal. Guy at the Panama Canal is just like, oh, fucking bitch. They have CEOs, too. I learned that.
The canals?
The canal is a company.
Yeah, someone owns that
someone
and
owns
allows
the
passage through it.
Right, so they have CEOs. It's the thing I learned this week.
It's not, you know, something they call gynecologists. They have CEOs to canals. That was not good. Never mind. Brien, what were you going to say?
At least when it bombs, it's not racist.
There's no following up that. We're good. All right, let's move on.
I can't think.
When it bombs, it bombs.
I can't structure real words.
Okay, Brien. Real world opinion. What do you think of Lil Nas X? We all going to hell?
Who's that?
Excellent. All right. So, heavily copyrighted material cannot play on the podcast, but Old Dirt Road, not Old Dirt, what song? Yippee-ki-yay, horses in the back. What does he sing? The first one?
Old Town Road?
Old Town Road. You know
Old
that
Country
song?
Road?
Yeah.
Old Town Road.
Old Town Road.
He made a new song.
Yeah.
That horses in the back guy?
Yeah, yeah.
He put out a song about the devil.
Oh, no.
And he looks like a chick, kind of like a Satan girl in the video, and everyone's freaking out. We're like, we're going to hell, we're going to hell.
Oh yeah, for sure.
And it's like all the outrage and da, 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 and it's like turning people into the devil.
I figured you had
an opinion on that.
So
but I guess not.
So essentially, metal is passing the torch,
right? And so I thought that was interesting because people were like, oh, blah, blah. I was like, well, okay, it's the same argument we've seen before. It's like the Nancy Reagan thing. It's like what your children consume is what they become. You know, like if you play shooty video games, they're gonna shoot people. I gotta like really not let the sound play on this because that would be bad.
Yeah, I haven't watched this either. I just don't care. And his shoes are stupid. Like, who gives a fuck?
So that's your main takeaway?
That's it. That's all I give a fuck about.
His shoes are stupid?
The everyone talking.
I thought you meant the video. You're like, honey. No. You're like, honey, those shoes don't work.
Yeah, complaining about his outfit in the video where he twerks on the devil. No.
Yeah, so that's the thing, right? Is he twerks on Satan? Which I get. I mean, that's, you know.
That's hot. I don't know.
It's edgy, for
Rock
sure.
Rock and roll.
But I mean, you know, I don't get it. Like, music's always been edgy. Like, this is nothing new. This is no, like.
In life,
uh-oh.
We hide the
parts. Oh, it's fine in our headphones. Oh, okay. It just can't be in YouTube.
Gotcha. I was like,
yeah, that's why if it plays on the laptop, big no-no, because YouTube will be like, hey. But here, but in our headphones, we can hear this and not. Montero's some place he created. I caught it bad just today. Pink guitar, sick. Okay. He looks like. Not in a while anyway. Right, dude. Dylan, that's you. I'm Lil Nas X, and you're the alien guy. And you're like, come on, get in this tree. I'm like, I'm gonna fucking Steven Seagal run out of here, dude. Look at him. He's like, later.
This is a wild video.
That song's kind of cool.
That's not me at all. I don't look like
it
that.
It looks just like you, dude.
That's... No. I don't know, man.
That's not Sid the Sloth.
You know? It's
yeah,
like...
exactly. Look at me.
This is like humans breeding with aliens, maybe? Is that what that's about?
Is it? I don't know.
Yeah, is this
I
like
I don't understand
a...
this stuff.
He's like, yo, like...
And then the Hunger Games.
I don't get art, I guess. I don't know. I don't... understand any of this stuff.
It's very subjective.
I mean, whoever directed the video, it's kind of cool. Like, those dope outfits and, like...
Yeah, but why? What is it?
They're on their way to America.
What?
Is this symbolism? Okay, but I'll fast forward to the scandalous part. I mean, he, in his journeys of a young black tranny or whatever the fuck, he...
That's a sweet rapper name.
He goes to
Young Black Tranny.
Yeah. I mean, it's just like, boom, you know? I mean, okay.
I mean, Slayer did it a different way, but I guess it's the same idea, right?
I don't see the outrage at all.
I mean...
Okay, it's like... You know, it's very gay.
Yeah, I got no opinion about this.
It's very gay.
I could give two shits.
Yeah, like, the news sucks right now. It's almost hesitated to bring up both stories. Like, ship is stuck and gay black guy exists.
Yeah, everything gets...
You know, like, oh my God, you know.
Everything gets real boring when everyone starts ignoring everything.
I know, we need a new war, a pandemic.
No,
like,
I
was getting sick about talking about COVID nonstop. Like, yeah. Not gonna lie, like, holy fucking shit. Like, you can only do so many podcasts where you bitch about, like, social justice warriors and fucking COVID, but, like, good lord, like, the ship's stuck is the hottest news. I mean, like, so there's gonna be a kitten getting involved, adopted
yeah,
somewhere.
Yeah, I don't...
Oh, they're finally doing the George Floyd fucking thing? Another
the trial
thing I
right
don't
now?
Wanna fucking talk about. It's like
oh, yeah,
six
I don't
week
even talk... yeah.
OJ-style thing. It's like, good
we
lord.
We were on the Discord the other night.
Now we're going to pout about the results, and there's going to be more fucking Molotov cocktails and shit, and I get it, but it's like, good lord. Like, when does it all end, man? Trump 2024. I'm just kidding. We're coming back, dude. We're coming back to fucking huck you over the wall again.
We need it.
Just kidding.
Yeah, Josh can't throw that high.
He's just joshing you.
Exactly, dude.
He's just joshing you. That's good, actually. I don't know why we really like.
So,
oh my god, something in my notes that fucking pissed me off and I forgot to talk about it. If I was walking down the street.
Okay.
And you're walking down the street.
Okay.
Just minding your own business. We know each other. And I'm like, hey, you look thirsty. Have this drink, right? And you're like, well, what is this drink? And I'm like, oh, it's a grapefruit sparkling water. You'd be like, oh, I hate grapefruit. No, thank you, right? As a normal, I mean, everyone hates grapefruit. We can all agree, grapefruit, gross. Now, if I was walking down the street, same situation, and I was like, would you like this drink? And I'm like, oh, yeah, well, what flavor it is? And I'm like, well, it's a Pamplemouse. And you would go, well, I mean, I, what the fuck is that, right? What the fuck is a Pamplemouse? I'm from America. And be like, oh, well, it's a grapefruit. And then I would strike you down, and I'd be like, why would you try to trick me with the enemy's language here? Stop with the fucking naming, LaCroix. This is the fifth letter I've written to you, and no one's called me back. No one's written me back. I've posted on your social media to change the name. I don't know what the fuck a Pamplemousse is. I looked it up. It says grapefruit. You're liars. But just name it grapefruit, because I've been deceived. I'm minding my own business at my computer. Hate grapefruit.
That's
weird. Hate it. Can't stand it.
Seems really
weird.
It's
a bitter, disgusting, worthless fruit. The only thing the grapefruit is good for is that one video where the chick puts a dick in it and she goes, gol, 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 that one.
Yeah. Yep, I remember
Best
that.
Best use of a grapefruit in whatever year that happened. But to trick a man in America into drinking grapefruit sparkling water by calling it Pamplemousse, first of all, what's a Pamplemousse? Second of all, change it. Okay.
Shouldn't buy something until you understand
what it is. I didn't. She tricked me. She's like, oh, I want you to try Pamplemousse. Right. I want you to try Pamplemousse. Fully knowing that I don't like grapefruit,
she
goes to the store and she purchases it. Gives it to me. What do you think? And I'm like, I don't know. I don't like it. It kind of tastes like bile. She's like, that's grapefruit. I'm like, this is just the big elaborate fucking joke. She played on me. Just to play on words, just to get me to drink fucking poison. Like, not
grapefruit
cool.
Seems like a weird thing that you wouldn't like.
I hate it. It's bitter and gross.
What
it's
else
like
do you hate? You don't hate orange. A lot of food.
Green bell peppers and grapefruit. That's about it. I'll eat a real grapefruit, but like, what are we doing? You put the sugar on it. You get the spoon that's got the serrated edges. Like, I need a special spoon to eat this fucking disgusting orange. It's bitter. It needs sugar on it. Like,
you'll eat an artichoke though, right?
I will. I will dip it in mayonnaise.
Yeah, but that's a lot of work.
That's what you do, right? We're dipping artichokes into mayonnaise.
I don't eat artichokes.
You don't eat artichokes?
He eats nothing.
You're just keto.
Well, no, it's the way keto. He made a point the other day because I said something about something tasting better. Hot dogs, because he's microwaving his hot dogs. I was like, boil those at least. Like, come on, dude.
Yeah, I like a good boiled dog.
Boiled dog. Boiled fucking dog. That's microwave a good question. How you barbecue. Have your hot
dogs. Go to the extra effort.
30 seconds, nuke them.
Yeah, okay.
Boom.
And then I talked about taste. And he goes, have you seen me eat? I just hoof it down. Taste doesn't really matter that much. And I'm like, you're right. Like, and they got me thinking, like, if I didn't enjoy food, what would I be like? Because I like food. I enjoy
it. If this is how skinny you are and you eat pizza at my house every weekend, you'd be fucking Auschwitz, dude.
Yeah.
Like.
Yeah.
German?
But I love food. So.
Oh, by the way, we took the 23s and me's, right before the show,
spit in a little vial.
We couldn't eat or drink or smoke or brush our teeth for 30 minutes, and it was the hardest thing I've ever done. I can't go 30 minutes without brushing my teeth, first of all, but not drinking and smoking and all the other, it was this long list.
We had already started.
It was
that,
like,
that was the problem.
It was rehab, dude. It was a life-changing, We all went through it together. It was a fucking ordeal, but for 30 fucking minutes, we couldn't drink whiskey, eat pizza, drink water. I had to stop continually brushing my teeth. There was no jogging. There was no Pilates. You couldn't drink coffee. And I think that was it.
All the yoga mats were rolled up.
No yogurt.
Yoga mats.
You couldn't even, there was like, don't watch the Food Network in this 30 minutes. Like, it was very restrictive. And then you spit in a vial, and it's so fucking disgusting because you're just collecting your spit and watching it spit. And then in the descriptions, I had to ask the disgusting question of, like, do I go to the line of the spit, or do I go to where, like, the foam, the top of your...
The foam's gross.
And I'm like, this is gross. That's I need to know this, though. Part. And then the instructions are like, oh, yeah, go to the line, not the foam. I'm like, ugh. Think of handling that much spit all day. You're the guy that's like, boop-a-doo-doo-doo, opening up vials and just being like, boop-a-doo, a little bit.
Dumping it into the cloning machines.
Yeah, just botching
and stuff,
all the shit. Yeah.
Mixing gene splicing with all your
Bill
spit.
Bill Gates shows up and you put him in a suitcase. He's like, thanks, buddy. And like, that's all you do all day, just handle saliva. Like,
it's got to be like, I bet it's a lot like a trashier version of working at like a blood bank, like, or like at a blood lab, you know, the people that receive the blood.
I think it's more upscale.
I don't think so.
You're like, you know what I mean? You're like basically like deciding who's what. You're just being like,
you're not deciding anything.
I think they're in there. You know what I mean? You know what I'm saying? I think they're selling our spit to China and they're doing something with it. You know, they're crafty. They're doing something with all the spit. They're making
weapons that we had to specific to our DNA.
Yes, give us round eye spit. Yes,
we had to consent to like 7 different things. Yeah, like, yeah, I can say you can have this and store it and keep it. And
you can store my spit. You can use it in tests, but it was optional. You could say no. You could say do not test my spit, and they're probably going to do it anyway. So they're like, definitely test that one then.
Yeah. What are you hiding?
You know, he's got that spit that makes you jump high. And then there was something else to consent to, like linking the two together or something, like
Using it in studies, contacting you.
Or like, can we contact you if we want to do like research? And it's like,
then we start talking about
that. Appeals to your ego, though. You're just like, yeah, I want to, like, they're like, dude, send me some letter, like, we need to study you. I'm like, I knew
you get a phone call and you're like, who the fuck, what is it, Canada? And you just swipe it thinking it's scam or whatever. You get a pick it up and you're like, hey, this is 23andMe, and we wanted to talk to you about your sample. We found something interesting, and you're like, you just hang up, and then all day you have to think about, what does interesting mean?
Yeah. Sir, did you shit in the tube?
Samuel L. Jackson from S.H.I.E.L.D. calls up, hey, motherfucker, you're on X-Men! You're like, sack, dude! Yes, dude!
So you ready to get blood red mad? Like, blood red, man. Like,
is a surprise.
I drank all week.
I knew it!
You called it.
I called it Monday and Tuesday.
Because you said, because everyone was like, Dylan's talking a lot for normal. And he's like, he's either manic or drinking. And I was
And you were
both.
Like, hmm?
And I was
busted, dude.
Keep also, there's one more. I smoked a cigarette last night.
You fucking piece of shit. I just smoked peanut butter whiskey on my shorts that don't match.
Just one. And
I want one cigarette.
And I didn't like it, if that helps.
He came back in rubbing his nipples. He was like,
Did you have low energy afterwards?
Yeah, no, I felt like shit.
That was the thing I noticed. Is like,
I feel so bad.
Yeah, when you haven't smoked and then you have another cigarette, it's like, you can feel it like pumps the
pulse. Well, and the alcohol too. I'll go back next week. Yeah. I felt like shit this week. It.
He gets on Discord with all of us. Okay, two things. Dylan's not a good buyer. Okay, he's just a fucking, you know, flyer. I'm a flyer, not a good buyer. That's me. I'm Dylan. He just leaves out of Discord. We'll just fucking close. We're like, oh, we'll hear the boop-a-loop little sound. That's Dylan leaving. Never says goodbye. Monday and Tuesday, full-on conversations, and said goodbye to Waffles. And even Waffles was like, what the fuck? Dylan said goodbye to me. I was like, oh, really? And I wrote it down in a little notepad. Then Tuesday, he gets on. He's like, oh, hi, guys. I'm like, oh, my God. That sounds like someone who was having withdrawals and then finally got his medicine. That's what that sounds like. I know that tone of voice. Sure as shit. You're a bad advocate.
I'm terrible.
You should have ratted him out. You should have ratted it out so that I could have been like, well, actually, Brien and me, you know, and I would have had the documents so that.
Yeah, but I was going to tell you, like, either way. It's not, well, like I was going to lie to you about it.
Here's what I wanted to do. I wanted you to be like, you want to get blood red, man? I'd be like, sure, Dylan, go ahead. And you were like, this week? And I'd put my hand on your lip. And I'd go, stop. I know. And then you just, like, a single tear will come down your face. And then I'll just walk out
shame.
The room.
Yeah. Just leave.
I know.
Yeah, so I went way off the wagon this week.
Wait, you're not talking about, like, I had a couple Coors Lights and fucked a moose. Like, you...
Actually, no, I didn't drink a lot this week. I think I had... It was like a 12-pack all week. 12-pack all week.
12-pack all week, split over every single day? You drink every day?
Yeah.
You're fucking bad.
You're fucking bad.
Fucking bad, dude. I'm gonna go smoke for 5 days. I feel like I earned a cigarette because you drank. No. How weird is that?
That's
my brain.
Or did you earn a cigarette because he got a cigarette?
Right. No. I double earned a cigarette, so I get two cigarettes.
Two cigarettes, yeah.
That's how my brain works. You fucked up, so
you can't buy single cigarettes, though. So
I could buy a pack and sell him a single cigarette.
That would be a good little hustle.
That's ridiculous, dude.
I'd be like Big Pharma.
And then you'd be selling him single cigarettes, dude.
Slowly dish
them
out.
I would need them. I was drunk last night. That was my...
But you have to stand on a corner somewhere and sell them, though. I want to be able to like pull up and be like,
ATF will fucking shut me down.
That's who busts you.
I literally just got flagged on this podcast for saying I'm going to go sell single cigarettes.
I'm going to sell single cigarettes.
No, you're good. You're white.
I'm going to say you're white.
I'll go fuck it. They're going to go find me on the res.
So, yeah, that happened. I regret it.
Do you feel
helps.
Shame?
He does.
A little bit. No, not really. I actually feel more physical, like just ailments. That's what I feel bad about. Not so much like the.
Like when you drink, I feel like shit.
Like the next day.
Yeah.
Yeah. The bags under my eyes are way worse. And so I can physically tell in like my.
So you were starting to feel healthy from not drinking.
Yeah. And that was a big wake up, actually. Because now I can, like, that was the first time I've been able to directly correlate it to that. Because I was, like, getting better, and then all of a sudden it was like...
I want to drink again.
That first 2 days I drank, I was just like, oh,
what made you go, I'm feeling good?
Who would have thought drinking a six-pack a day would make you feel like shit?
I know. What was the day in the moment when you were like, I'm feeling good, I haven't drank in a week, I'm going to fuck that up? Monday?
No, Monday I was in a bad mood for some reason.
Because your dad left?
That was a long time ago, but yeah. No, I don't remember why. I don't remember. I'm pissed. I'm always pissed off about something, though.
Just the rocks at work.
It was something. Yeah, something.
Just the rocks weren't right.
I don't remember.
The rocks didn't stack right that day.
Well, I mean, that's life. That's a good. Sometimes the rocks just don't stack.
Shout out to rocks. Stacking.
Totes.
I fucking hate countertops, dude.
It's very interesting. Next week, hopefully. No. I don't know how long fucking the mail takes, but the idea is the 23andMe's are going to come back. Now, do they come back to each other's houses? They have return addresses?
All right. How does
the mail work?
I'm going to talk real fucking slowly because we've talked about this.
Okay, we've talked about this.
You don't get anything in the mail.
It comes into my app, right. Yeah, we talked about this.
You made it. I don't know if you did yet, but the rest of us already...
Well, I hope you did.
Do you like my shitty facial hair?
It's gross.
It's gross, huh? Yeah.
Grow it out.
Yeah, if you're wondering, this is not what I wanted to do.
Grow it out.
It got fuzzy this week.
Don't be a pussy.
And I was going to shave it because I just let it go. And Janelle's like, no, keep it. I like it. I'm like, what? So I just embraced it. I'm like, I'm going to keep this and I'm going to dress like I sell pills this week.
And then you're going to sell pills.
Yeah, I'm going to do the worst podcast ever and look like I sell pills. That's my goals for this week, so.
Check it off the list.
Check it off the list.
Yeah, dude, you've really accomplished a lot this week.
I have, dude. We were good today. We did some podcast work. We like edited some shit.
Yeah.
We tried.
Yeah.
Oh, okay. I do have one story from this week. Hopefully she's not listening.
Probably.
She's my neighbor. She's either like, she might be physically listening, like because like she's right there.
Yeah.
So where the studio is, there's a window. The face is my fucking neighbor, and it's really fucking close. So I keep the window shut so she doesn't hear dicks and pussies and shit. But she's my neighbor, so she sees me coming and she sees me going. And we borrow cups of sugar and do neighborly things, right? We trade plants. I've fucking seen her tits. You know, like, things have happened. It's been a long relationship. But it's gotten to the point where it's insane the amount of overshare and how comfortable. Like, have you ever had someone, like, overextend their end of the relationship?
Yeah, always.
Like,
well, I mean,
we're friends. And then they're like, oh, good. I'm glad we're friends. Now I can go, you know, like this thing. Like, hey, do you want to... fucking look at my pap smear results and shit. The other day, shit you not. We're both at our respective computers because we have his and her computers, dude. And we are playing video games. Her phone rings. It's Terry. Terry's our next door neighbor. Sorry, and we're back. All right, so she hits me up and she hits Janelle up. I'm like, what is it? Terry needs to come over to her house right away. I'm like, oh, fuck, it's an emergency. Something's on fire. So there's a rapist. We go over there. I'm fucking pissed. I'm in the middle of my, you know, Scandinavian theme RTS. I'm eating some fucking tapioca. So we go next door. And, oh, you know, I need you to tell me if there's a propane leak. I'm like, okay, I should.
Man up.
I should walk with my elbows out, you know. And we go over there. come in my kitchen. I think that's where the leak is. I need you to smell. I need a second opinion. I need a second nose. Like, I'm making nose jokes, you know. So we go in there. I'm smelling. I don't smell any gas leak. Just smells like kind of like a dirtier kitchen. Sorry. Just smells funky. I'm like, no, it smells fine. She's like, I didn't know if it was like an egg. I don't know. I look at the water heater. None of the pilots are out. Nothing's leaking gas. Breathing really deep. I'm like sniffing around. She's got a little roommate's area over here. I'm smelling where the roommate lives. There's like a bathroom over there. I'm smelling all around where there's like pipes and things. Nothing. Breathing very deep. Go home. Get to text, or maybe she saw her in the driveway the next day. She's like, oh no, my roommate ate some bad food and I thought the egg smell was a gas leak. And I'm like, oh, well, you know, thank God it's been resolved. But also, you fucking invited me over to inhale your roommate's farts. So I feel betrayed, to say the least.
Fucking off in some stranger's
ass. I breathed.
Ass.
So I was looking for a gas leak in an old woman's house. I've never breathed in harder than when you're looking for a gas leak in an old woman's house. Yeah. That or running from a thousand sharp hay puppies. I'm breathing in. I'm in danger detection mode. I'm a basset hound. I'm trying to save a life. I'm like, is there a gas leak? Jerry, Larry, Barry, whatever the fuck in the next room. I was just like, no, I had, you know, old country buffet. And I'm fucking inhaling so much of it. So, you know, fucking shout out, Terry, fuck off, you know. Also, your house is pink. Change it. Fucking paint your pink fucking house. I know you can hear me. Paint your house. It's pink, okay? Sorry, I just need to get that off my chest. But yeah, I breathed deep the fumes of another man's colon.
Yeah, you did.
In an emergency situation. I thought I was saving a life and I was breathing a fart.
You know, that's kind of like when people go like, oh, you smell popcorn and someone breathes deep, but you really just shit your pants. Oh. She just got you with the ultimate.
She's like, my life's in danger.
Yeah, come on over. Yeah.
She fucking
dude.
They're all fucking laughing. You, dude. They're all laughing.
That's what she
shit.
Did. It was intentional.
Oh my God.
She just fucked you up, bro. She was probably farting too.
I felt had.
Dirty eggs, bro. That's what you get when you try to help out an old lady.
Yeah.
I guess there's a lesson to be made here.
Yeah,
don't help
people.
Anybody out ever.
Ever.
You might just get a mouthful of fucking fart dust.
Mm-hmm. I got godded.
Yeah, you did.
So what are you going to do to her?
I have no way of retaliating, honestly. Well, actually,
I'm going to make a propane link.
I guess maybe I'm going to have a gas leak. I'm going to eat only fucking Mexican food the day before and just...
shit on her porch.
Yeah, I don't know how to... I can't get her back. She did. It was an honest mistake. But it's just... the constant oversharing. I mean, I will pull up to the driveway and she'll be like, hey, just letting you know I'm going to the dump, which is cool. She has a truck. I don't have a truck. I'm less of a man. I'll throw trash in the back of your truck and you can take it to the dump for me. That's cool. If you need this old tire, you can have it. I'm like, I don't, what? If you want this, I have a plate with a chip in it. Do you guys want this? I'm like, nope. You know, like, do you guys have any broken chairs I can get? I'm like, yeah, sure. You know, just weird transactions back and forth. Like, do you have... a bottle with a little bit of lotion left in it that you're not using anymore? Like, yeah, take it, you know? She's like, I got all these leaves. Do you want them? I'm like, nope. Do you want to see
She's
my...
just getting ready for the
it's
fucking
just
apocalypse, man. The buttering.
It's a weird relationship. She asked me, she's like, oh, you're going to do your fence this year? I'm like, yeah, I'm going to do my fence. She's like, well, if you do your fence, what if I paid you to do my fence? I'm like, well, I'm paying someone else to do my fence. And she's like, no, and I'll pay you to do my fence. I'm like, I'm paying someone to do my fence. Because I'm morbidly obese, I'm not gonna do your fence shitty while watching my fence done. Like, we're gonna pay Emmanuel and, you know, whatever to just do the whole length, you know? You pay them. That's your fence. I'm not building your fence for you. It's just. And then the newest construction project she's approved is you can hear the hammering.
The front porch.
Yeah. All good. Cars should stay dry. I get it. You know, I fucking hope you get raccoons, but like. If you paint it pink to match your house, I swear to fucking God. Just don't paint it pink. That'll be the olive branch. If she builds it and she's like, and I'm going to paint it, you know, the color of the house will eventually be or something that's not pink, fucking paint it brown. I don't care. But if she paints the fucking carport that she's building, which I can see from my yard.
So
it's,
bad,
it's,
I hope so.
It's in my, I'm that guy. Like, I can see it. It's an eyesore. But fuck, if she paints it pink, dude, we have a war. It's on, right? So if she paints it pink, that window's open every weekend. And we're going to shout her out live in the podcast. And we're going to, you know, that's going to be an interactive. She'll be like the guy from, what was the guy from Tool Time?
Wilson?
Yeah, fucked the kids. Yeah, yeah, Wilson. Fucked the kids. Yeah, didn't they find out he fucked kids?
Like in real life?
Yeah.
Oh, what?
I think he was a kid fucker. Yeah. I think he was like looking over other fences.
I think he's just 100% made that up, but that'd be awesome.
I don't think I did. I think it was like back in there.
We're going to look that up.
But yeah, he was caught looking over some school fences, if you know what I mean.
Yeah, dude.
And not colleges.
Straight peeking.
And not high schools.
Yeah. Just straight peeking on
not
them
the super
Grady's,
seniors.
Dude.
He wasn't looking at the super seniors.
Yeah. The Grady's is what they call them in the business.
What are you Googling? Did Wilson rape kids? Dope, dude.
That's a good one.
That's the kind of research you can expect on this show.
Yeah.
Dude. I would never throw out an accusation like that unless I was personally affected.
Oh, you threw out a what?
I had a couple whiskeys. I had a couple whiskeys. I'm going to stop doing that.
Call an ambulance.
Before the podcast, I am. Get a little loose. Going to stop doing that. But I'm pretty sure he fucked kids.
Or maybe we should just get as loose.
Ooh. Yeah, dude.
I'm pretty loose.
Well, you're in the doghouse, dude. You got too loose on the week.
Loose.
You got loose when it wasn't time to get loose.
I was loosey-goosey before it was
okay. When we were all tight, you were loose, and
dude.
It was inappropriate.
I was loose all
it
week.
It was inappropriate.
Hey, guess what? Super loose
all
week.
You're not supposed to be doing that.
I was, like, eating edibles and, like, bong
hits
and drinking
edibles
beer.
Are fine.
I know,
that's
but I was just, life. I was, like, one step away from popping muscle relaxers for no reason.
You do, you're gonna, you better, like, have kids so you can leave them or something, you know?
I don't want to do that.
What's the point of being a degenerate if you have no one to like be a
to abandon?
To? Yeah, you have
I'm
no
a
one to,
my parents.
To no one to disappoint, dude. Takes long sit look at ice cubes. He's like, there's just like the soundtrack to some Quentin Tarantino like film playing in his head as he looks at the ice cubes melting. He's like, well, I don't know how to answer that question. Maybe the whiskey will help.
Guess I just gotta keep living.
So Wilson did like
I don't got good enough
in between filming. I guess it's true. So you heard it here first, or
boom.
You heard it here.
Yeah, no,
we confirmed
fact.
It.
Actually, fact.
Wilson
fact.
Used to diddle kids. Yep. He used to. That wasn't the only fence. That's where they got him. They were like, oh, look at that guy looking over the fence. He's really good at that. And they're like, we need someone to play the guy that lives next door. He's got cute eyes and looks over fences really good. And
stay behind the fence so you didn't see his fucking
right. You couldn't see the
ankle monitor.
Horribly deformed from multiple trips to
that
prison.
He's in his fucking.
Yeah.
Jumpsuit from jail.
From Wilson from the nose down is just a beast.
Well, if you
scarred.
Actually, you know, if you go back and rewatch a lot of the Home Improvements, a lot of the times when Tim goes to go over the fence to talk to him,
mm-hmm.
he has a little baggie of Coke that he drops it
right. He's like,
on that top rack and he takes it. And they actually caught him giving it to the kids. That was kind of part of the.
Did you see the episode where they showed Wilson's apartment too? Or his house. I'm not an architect.
Not good at improv.
I'm not an architect, okay? I'm not an architect. But you go in there, it's all feng shui. It was very,
fake.
You know what I mean? Like Coke dealer. It was very, like, yeah. They had a vibe.
Sterile?
To it wasn't
was
like
it
Tim's
very
house.
Sterile?
Yes. It wasn't like Tim's house. There wasn't like, you know, bleached bangs and like,
yeah.
There's a pot roast.
Frampton
thing,
comes alive
very,
was on
yeah.
all the time.
Yeah, it was very like music in the background, some incense. And he's like, come in. But then, of course, they're hiding his face. We're like, hey, you're making him. You're feeding into this whole he touches kids, and then you find out he does touch kids, and it's just like.
But we haven't found out yet.
It's like what happened.
Well, no,
with
he did.
No, he did. We
it's
looked
fact,
it up.
Actually.
I came in. I did my research. Proven fact. I didn't just pull that out.
What,
of thin
what are your
air.
What are your sources?
Us.
My brain.
Yeah.
The internet. I it's true. Look it up yourself if you don't believe me. Wilson. What's the actor's name?
I don't know. He didn't do anything else. It's not like the dude was known
oh,
for
no,
anything.
He did other things.
But you just wouldn't know because he'd never seen his
what's
face.
What's his actor name? What's his real name?
What's
not Wilson. What's his... Fred Pardo? What is it, isn't it? Fred Pardo? Pardo?
Fred Pardo.
All right. Well, you know. Yeah.
It's fact. No, that's fact. We don't need to look it up.
It's fact, dude.
So, well, congratulations. I don't know on what. I guess on winning.
Earl Hendman?
Yeah. Yep. Did Earl Hendman diddle kids?
Yeah, there you go.
Rape allegations.
Make sure you put diddle.
Maybe type in rape allegations.
Well, when did he diddle them?
It doesn't matter. Just...
During the Home Improvement, there was some grooming and diddling. And then after, there was definitely some diddling.
To like kids on set?
And then he died.
So now he died of lung cancer in 2003.
He died of lung cancer, right? Yep, sounds right.
Smoking all those cigarettes, mm-hmm. watching kids.
Yep.
At the playground.
I mean, what the fuck else are you doing in his backyard? The guy didn't even have Wi-Fi. He was just
burying people.
Well, yeah, I mean, also in his theater where he was making the kids do their naked plays, he would be able to smoke in that theater.
He fucked Jonathan Taylor Thomas, all right? I'll say it.
No, he
I'll say it.
I'll say it. I'll come out and say it live on the air. He fucked Jonathan Taylor Thomas. He also cut his hair.
You know, I don't see anything about him touching kids.
They must have buried it. They probably buried it.
They probably buried
it. It's actually, it's probably like an OJ or right.
They buried
a,
it.
A
they buried
thing.
It because I made it up, but they also buried it because it's not true. But they also buried it because they wouldn't want people to know that. You know, they want to hide because you know that's a that shows it's an empire. Hero. That's a dynasty, right? That's
hero.
That's a that shows a
all the
it's a part of America.
All the
to be
knowledge
honest.
He gave.
Right. Right.
Sometimes. Right. Sometimes you know you just got to put up with little stuff to for a hero.
Right.
Sometimes. I think sometimes we can make an exception.
Man, talk about a guy who definitely had ED. Tim the Toolman Taylor.
Oh, yeah.
Guy definitely couldn't get his dick hard.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
If you're attaching, he's like, I put a motor on the toaster. Like, Tim, just go to the doctor, dude. Like, I mean, like,
just get
the toaster's cool, but, like, you're in a sexless marriage, dude. Like,
oh, he's got fucking dildos on power
drills. Yeah, he's like, I'm making fucking, like, dildos that have more power. She's like, hey, so my cervix is damaged from the last thing you invented. I really just want you to, like, figure out how to make your dick work. He's like, or, you know, whatever. He was like, bark. He was like,
So did they not show
Wilson's...
He would
avoid the subject and be like, what are you talking about, you know?
So they not show Wilson's face because the kids actually look more like Wilson than they do Tim?
Because... See, and it's unraveling. He's in the sexless marriage because, you know, he's just, his dick doesn't work. He's Tim the Toolman Taylor. He's fucking, you know...
Overcompensating.
Wilson's fucking the kids, fucking the dog, fucking the wife, making the meatloaf, and burning the incense, and listen to fucking who's the
Frampton Comes Alive.
Yeah, who? What was the duo? Barnes and Noble, Frampton. And...
Hall and Oates.
Hall and Oates. Barnes and Noble.
Got some sick books.
Yeah. Dude, hey, books. You know, he's just over there doing everything, and Tim's just like, well, at least I have a TV show and my gay bear lover who I co-host.
Al Borland?
Like, Al Borland. Hey, that guy is the bottom. Bro, the only time it does get hard is for a little baby Al, dude. Little baby Al's like, let me unbutton my flannel and get on my knees, and the fucking stage lights come on. I'm like, no one's at the studio. He's like, just, I want the power saw running in the background while you fuck me in the ass. You know, just that kind of shit's going on.
I feel like there is
JT's
some, like...
JT's waiting in the car like, Dad, I have my bang appointment. We need to go.
You're going to be fucking writing some fandom.
Like, yeah, exactly. Dude, I know. I'm like accidentally like rule 37-ing myself. Like, oh, dude, there's no home improvement porn. Oh! Right when they come. Oh! On the girl's tummy. You know what I mean?
On the girl's tummy.
Stop,
on
you're
going to
make me Oh my God, more power.
And then Wilson on the other side, but it's a glory hole. Because he, you know, no face. Glory.
Okay. Yeah. I thought you were going to draw a comparison to Hitler and Tim the Toolman Taylor. But like, we're just both looking for more power, but.
Oh, I didn't.
But you went a different
direction.
Sorry. Yeah, glory hole.
I was going on the next scene, I guess. Oh, okay. Next scene, sorry.
But yeah, they're, that show's got.
It's bad.
There's something to
it's
it.
Very bad, too. Like, on a real standpoint, it's not great. Went back to try
Have
to watch it.
Have you revisited it?
Yeah, it's.
Did you watch it when you were a kid?
It's rough. Yeah.
Oh, I thought, I mean, nostalgically, the show is killer.
Oh,
right?
Nostalgically, it's fantastic.
In my mind.
So is Mortal Kombat, but it's one of the worst movies ever made.
The old one?
Yeah. Absolutely. Yeah.
Oh, that plot just, like, just
Does
moves.
It?
Like
You're like in America, and then, Japan, and then the island in within, like, 4 minutes, and you're like, I
oh,
don't
no,
know
died.
What's going on.
Oh, and, a portal, walk in.
He die. Yeah.
Finish him.
The new one looks like it'll be just as bad.
No.
Hey, be careful. He is all about
is
this
Is he
new
all
one.
Invested?
I think the new one's
He's got the Mortal Kombat NFT already.
I think so. Don't.
It was a gentleman's pour. That's what we call, in the business, that's what we call gentleman's pour.
Oh, okay.
In the business.
Okay.
I call
hey,
that,
I got a par yesterday.
I call that roofing.
What's that?
It's where you hit the ball in the hole, like, in the, what you're supposed to.
So just got you did golf.
I did golf.
You're average.
You did.
Yeah. On one hole.
Mom, I got a C. She's like, that's cool, honey. Your father's been gone for 40 years. You know, like, congratulations. Go to the store and get your mother's cigarettes. See if your father's still there.
But Mom, it's been 10 years. I don't think he's still at the grocery.
Just go. menthol checkers and some SpaghettiOs.
Get some milk so you can have Cheerios for dinner. My mom wasn't that trashy, but that's fairly close to my
mom. Your mom always turns into a Jew when I do an impression of her.
I don't. Yeah, she's
always New York Jew.
Any kind of East Coast, yeah. You
it's
going
to let me down if I meet her and she's like, hello, I'm Dylan's mother. And I'm like,
well, yeah,
oh,
she's definitely
fuck.
Not like East Coast at all.
How does she talk?
Like a normal.
Do an impression of your mother.
She kind of just sounds like me.
Oh, no. Oh, no.
She's really just.
Dude, your dad's a fucking hero. He can get it up for that. She's like, I'm home. You're like, the fuck, dude? She's a fucking perfect angel. Like, Dad, you're fucking huffing gasoline if you think that's attractive. She's like, what are you talking about, Dylan? Like, you sound like a fucking Flintstone, Mom. I don't know how Dad gets it up for fucking. Speaking of ED, like, you sound like VeggieTales over here. Like, I don't know how you had kids. Fuck, one of them turned out gay, so I'm going to say the voice had something to do with it. Is that really what she sounds like? Just
know.
Like you?
No, not just like me. I don't know. I can't do an impression of my mom.
Yeah, you can. Come on. You know her.
I literally
out of her.
Can't. I don't know.
You know your mom better than anybody.
That's not true, probably.
Who knows your mom better? See?
You're right. I can't do an impression of her, though. I can't, like, formulate
well,
then,
until I meet
head.
Her, she's a New York Jew. She's got cigarettes. She's got cigarettes. So there's, like, cigarette Dylan's mom, and there's, like, Dylan. You know, like...
Yeah, you have both sides.
But I don't know. I need to hear...
You do need to.
I'm going to be let down if it's just a normal...
It's just normal.
Or if it sounds like you, though.
I guess that's kind of what I mean. It's kind of just normal. She doesn't really have, like, an accent.
But it's a feminine voice. Your dad's not like
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
Okay.
No, it's not like he's...
You're like, she's gruff, but, you know.
She's rough.
Oh, you're like, what does that mean? He's like, you know what the...
Even someone like you can understand what I mean about this.
She will, if you know what I mean. Woo! Zing! She will, woo, please stop sucking, it hurts. You know what I mean? Like, you ever have that where you're like, hey, stop, okay. I get it. Whoa, but like, now it hurts, okay? Like, no?
Are you asking that seriously?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, no.
Not with your mom doing it to you, but like another person doing. No, have you ever sucked your own dick until it was wrong? That was a question I was asking. I was going to today make us all do the Kinsey scale. It's a gay test. Thought it was pertinent since we're three.
What's that?
We're three line walkers here. There was this guy who was like the king of all gays. It was like Albert Kinsey or whatever. I think he was a scientist. Probably wasn't king of gays, but he came up with a test for how to identify his fellow people. And it's super not scientific, and it's only 7 questions, but it'll just be like, you're gay, dude.
Like you can do that on your phone?
You can do it on your phone. And we have a guest coming who it would make a really good segment. So we're going to probably do it with him to just have him tell us as a gay person which one of us is more of a homo. Just so that I can talk shit about him or he can talk shit about me. But you can take the
well,
Kinsey scale.
Well, based on your fashion sense.
Based on my fashion sense?
You are not
gay
at
student.
All.
Oh, no. You're not. You're straight as
yeah,
shit.
Yeah, I'm straight as no, the yellow brick road, no, bro. Yeah. Like, right now, in this thing.
Yeah.
The only way that could be a gay outfit is if that sweatshirt was a crop top and you were 200 pounds
okay,
lighter.
But you're not giving me the credit for the sweatshirt is
I
a
hate,
cutoff.
Why? How many of those
did you get? I have a long
get?
Sleeve. I have
a
long
black
sleeve.
One too. You
I did get a black one.
Pleb.
So this new style
you know,
I'm working on.
You know, you could be like a lesbian gay.
Right. So
but you
this is
be
my
a
new style,
gay.
Right? Sweat shorts and hoodie that's a t-shirt with a hood.
You're like white.
But it's still a thin sweater, so it's like a spring sweater.
So you know, if you do get 1% black on this test, you can't wear this anymore.
Why?
Because this is the whitest shit there is.
Is this the whitest shit there is? It does look like trailer
actually,
park drug
actually,
dealer.
You know, if there is a little bit of black, it
I mean, I wore
it
ironically.
It
I would never, I literally would never leave the house looking like this.
Oh, yeah, true. You would.
You 100%
would.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You think I would leave?
You probably already have.
Unironically wear this?
You wear
I would,
sweatpants.
I would unironically wear one piece of this separately.
No.
With a black shirt.
Unironically?
I can see
yeah,
you getting ready to
matching?
Go to a fucking float, walking into Walmart to get beer in this outfit.
Okay. Yeah, 100%.
Okay.
What you honestly think you.
I feel like.
Oh, so you think you get dressed up to go outside?
I think my perception of this outfit is different. I put it on. It's funny. I would never wear this. And everyone's like, oh, he's just wearing one of those things.
Yeah.
Wow. Okay.
Your stick is getting old, I guess.
I know.
Really
I guess
old.
It's not. Yeah.
You
it's
get
not shocking.
Start
anymore.
Writing.
I got to start
jokes.
Little Nas X. Yeah.
No,
you
that's
you should
too.
Do that.
That's
you
boring.
Should start writing
jokes?
Anything. Letters to your dad. I don't know. Fucking whatever you want. Like, where are you?
Just start using words.
Just start shouting
time.
Into the horizon. You know what I mean? Like,
maybe with a counselor.
Exactly. I don't know. Get a prison pen pal and fucking, you know, write
Dude,
a letter.
That would be cool if we got a podcast prison
for the
pen
podcast.
Pal?
Should we get a pen pal for the podcast?
Why not?
What if he, like, what about Cinco?
I just want it to die.
Yeah, we should do that. We should get a prison pen pal. I wonder if you know anyone who's going to prison.
I think you can just probably sign up for it randomly.
Nowadays, they got fucking phones.
That's
and
what I mean.
Access.
I know. So you probably can get on a website and be like, hey.
That's less fun. I want it to be like, ride it with a feather.
Well, you might be able to. You probably you know can do mean? That, too. But you can probably
I
can
ride it with
meet,
a feather.
You can probably find.
With some ink, yeah.
Yeah, I want to like have a, like quill. A quill. I want to yeah. have a quill. And then the wax for no reason, you know? And you got the quill, the feather, and I'm like, hear ye, prisoner.
You're talking to one person.
On this day, you know, it's like in calligraphy.
You pay someone to go there and there and read it.
Yeah. It's like this just fucking.
All dressed up.
Really fragile paper that I got from like the. Some ancient Human Chinese skin. Dynasty. This is paper from the Ming Dynasty, and this feather's from the last crow in Africa or something, and the ink is from like the deepest ocean octopus. And then that's how I want to write the letter. I want to do it on like a cool stand. You know what I mean?
To a dude who robbed a convenience store?
Probably, yeah. And just have him not understand the forethought and the effort I put into it. He's like, what the fuck is this shit, man?
I recently found All right. out I'm 1% black,
yeah, exactly.
and I want to like, connect with you.
Hello. My 23andMe results came back, and I am 0.5 Southern African. And so I would like to start opening up communications between our races. I'm an ambassador of the race.
Shank.
So yeah, we have that. And that.
Yeah. So maybe next week. It'll come into our apps.
So before we get these results, we need to write down what we think
Brien has a good idea.
Each person is and ourselves.
So a guess to like sum it up or like here's a list. I think of these three things. I think
yeah, just
things.
Like whatever you think they're made up of.
Can I just snowball right now? Like,
yeah,
okay,
no,
so
let's finish that. Let's finish out on this. Let's
just
yeah.
ballpark because I don't have to write it down if I do it on the podcast. A little bit of Irish, Scots Irish, they call it. It's where the two fucked, right? Because they were like beating each other and they just fucked. And they came to America. It's a complicated story. Look it up. He's got some Scots Irish, a lot of Norwegian, and then just straight at like fucking like UK, like Cockney. You know what I mean? I'm saying Irish, Norwegian, English. And that's it. Like strictly European mutt. Northwestern European mutt.
Yeah, you're just a white guy.
You, German, you know what?
Don't say that.
I think like almost 100% Irish. Straight up. Like 78% Irish.
I think I might be a majority Irish. I think that's
I think you're very fucking Irish. And then like your great-great-great-grandpa's like a German guy.
Italian.
I
think you're wrong on that.
Or like a German guy married an Italian guy.
Yeah, maybe both.
And then they got
the guys
snuck
did?
In there.
And then the Nazis hunted them and they ran.
Something,
and...
yeah. You got some
beautiful
Italian
love story.
And you got some German. Now, there's also, is this the one where they tell you how much Neanderthal you are too?
I think so.
Because I'm interested about that too.
Because Ancestry doesn't do that. So if.
I don't know if I'm a caveman. Is it like,
I don't care what
that
says.
Like,
you are a caveman.
You think I'm going to be more Neanderthal?
No, I don't even care if it says you are. I know you are.
Since Shane Zingo was here, I want him to spit in the tube because
that
motherfucker's like 89% Neanderthal.
He's like 80% Neanderthal and 20% mammoth. Like he is like a weird fucking just.
That's for the Cro-Magnon
oh my
brow.
Oh god, that hair. Yeah. What is that?
Jewish.
Yeah.
The
way he was like smelling Ellie, it was like.
And you kept inviting
Can't
them back.
Can't do that.
No, yeah, you can do it.
This inside
you want.
Joke's brought to the Applied Please Stop podcast, and it will make sense when the court documents come out. So, see Article A in fucking
Exhibit B.
A couple years, maybe.
Just
I don't know.
Didn't know.
Just know that we had no fucking idea that he was potentially
a creep.
Is an at risk individual. And his appearances on this podcast are definitely over, and you know, Whoops.
Oopsie-daisy.
Brian's like, I have business ties. So, yeah, you know, that's over. It's fine, you know. So, you know, don't solicit nudes to kids in Mississippi. What else? Thomas
Brown. You look like Pacific Islander.
I do look like a... Right, so my guess for myself
and your native.
Pineapple eater, ching, 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 Native American.
You're kind of in that like, order. You're like the pineapple chicken kind of right. Pacific Islander.
I think I'm, yeah, I'm like other tan Asians that live around.
You're white Malaysian.
Right. White Norwegian. Like the white part, oh I know. God. I can verify the Norwegian. We know.
Yeah, you'd be a king.
We got
in
some
Malaysia.
Fucking, you know, those guys.
Mm, some white people.
In my, some fucking. Those Norwegian. You know what I mean? Come on, let's be honest. I mean, Norwegian people. A little sketchy, right?
Are they? Yeah. I don't know much about him. They kind of see
the Dragon Ball guy. Sketchy. Sketchy.
No, now I've known Christian a long time, mm-hmm. or Frederick, I guess, mm-hmm. is now
see,
what
two
he
names.
Likes to
go by. Sketchy serial killer.
Yeah,
right two there. First names.
Later. Watched him go through his religious break, mm-hmm. like where he was super Christian, and then one day
ooh,
was
we should
like,
do that to Keegan. Where we make him not religious, and then he comes back and helps us with the podcast.
That'd be sick.
That'd be dope. If
yeah,
he came back and he's like
yeah, bad. It's fake. Religion. Sorry. What was I talking about?
Norwegian.
Norwegian people are untrustworthy.
Oh yeah, he's got some sort of white power.
Keep in mind,
him.
Whatever you say
he's
about
a nice
Norwegian,
guy. Great guy.
Right. Whatever you fantastic say about Norwegian guy. People probably applies to me, and I'm being the first person to be like, I don't trust them. I think Norway was like, we wanted to ally with Hitler, we just didn't have the balls because we, you know what I mean? Like, they were very non-committal. They're like, we don't want to pick a side, but if we had to.
They're like yeah. they're like that white HOA. They're like, we're not racist because we've never, right. ever, ever dealt with anyone of yeah. a different race.
Because we don't have black people in our country or Jews, you know.
Yeah, our like, gated community.
Yeah.
Mm,
Norway, they, yeah, don't, you can't. So I
what they're plundering.
They're just, I mean, you look Norwegian, not going to lie. You look like.
Well, I've already had ancestry, so I know all my.
What? No, what do you think there's going to be differences? What are you primarily?
That's why I'm getting, I want to see.
Did I guess correctly?
I want to compare them.
But you're not going to tell me.
I mean, I've already done it.
Tell me what your ancestry is.
All right.
Because
well,
I think they're going to be radically different, dude. I think these things are
you
wildly
keep
inaccurate.
Doing your jib-jab, and I'll pull it up on their website.
I do not think you can trust these things. I've heard from multiple
yeah,
people that you take the test, and they start emailing you, like, oh, just kidding. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. Like, with all the percentages changing. And I get that's how numbers work. More people do it, the more data they get. But it's like, I don't know.
Well, my data changed big time with Ancestry over the years. As they narrowed down, and they got more DNA.
So then
and
which company has the biggest database, right? They're going to
be
the more accurate.
That would be more accurate.
And it's going to get like that over time. I mean, I guess eventually they'll both be really fucking accurate because they'll just have so much people's DNA and Bill Gates.
So I heard that it's very hard to get accurate Native American data because they
right.
won't turn in their DNA.
Ooh, that sounds racist.
Like they don't, they won't give up their
Indian
data.
People won't spit in it. Is that a thing though? Because I just spit in one.
I heard that it's really hard to use these tests to identify Native American ancestry because like no Native American people do these ancestry
in the past,
tests
especially I'm sure
yeah right. So it's like they have no way to go off of it
yeah and a lot like undocumented unregistered and they're like
they already don't trust the white man
right
they ain't about to spit in the tube for him
I mean I
don't blame them
yeah.
And they track their own history probably better than anybody so
yeah.
they know exactly
true.
Tribes and families and you know
yeah that's true.
They take any chance they can to tell us we're on their way.
Right, Chief Running Bear, you know, like, was related to Crying Wolf and.
Fuck, you got a lot.
I'm gonna find out I'm like 9/10 spear checker and be like, well, guess I gotta move to the plains, you know.
Oh, hopefully, because if
Ellie's
you're not,
fucking
what you just said's
yeah.
not. Okay.
I know. I can say spear checker because my daughter's registered Coeur d'Alene native. So, fuck off, you know.
I get a free pass through
I get
my
a free
kids.
Because my daughter is a what's a derogatory term for native?
I can tell you, can't say it on
something
the podcast.
Got a couple I can't say on the podcast, like prairie. and so, yeah. So yeah, we're gonna find out what we are, what I am. I'll finally know what I am. You'll all know what I am. We're going back and editing, and I was looking at like me last summer. When I'm tan, I do look like Pan Asian.
Oh, you get dark.
But I get an Asian dark, not
yeah.
like, it's weird. You know what I mean? Like,
yeah. Yeah.
It's Asian. But I also, you can't say Sacagawea. Did you know that?
Why?
There's a clip in there. C. Kogawea was your guess. That was your guess.
For what?
Sacagawea. It was like episode 4 of the YouTubes. Like,
was my guess.
You were talking about, you're like, what was that girl that John Smith? Yeah. C. Kogawea.
No.
C. Kogawea. I will post the clip. I will post the clip.
What's your fucking Wi-Fi password? Because I can't get service in here.
Oh, it's okay. Cool. No, that's the end. That's the end of the episode. But no, that's just the music cue. What were we looking up even?
I was trying to look up my ancestry data.
Oh. Oh.
But your internet, I can't get fucking
it's
service
in here.
It's
a metal wall. We're gonna find out hopefully next fucking week. Yeah. So just, you know what? Catch you later, because that was already way longer than I thought we were gonna go. Bye. Ha ha ha.